Good evening, everyone. I'm Carmine Jume. Let's get right into our March Madness. Our Poke women in the Sweet 16 of the WNIT tonight. They hosted Pepperdine with the winner headed to the Elite Eight. The result? Cowgirls win by one. 61-60 over Pepperdine. Bailey Cotton was 100% Cotton again. 15-5 for her. And how about Teresa Vitalova scoring 9 points and grabbing 3 boards while playing just 8 minutes? And Carla Aryavets was clutch for us again tonight. She made the go-ahead free throw with just 9 seconds left to give us the win. And how about the rest of the Cowgirls chipping in with leading scorer Marta Gomez held to just 5 points? The Wyoming women advanced to play Arizona in Tucson Sunday at 3 p.m. in the Elite Eight. And now to Region 9 hoops. Casper College's Isaac Bonton and Western Nebraska's Gervais Green just earned co-Region 9 Players of the Year. Bonton the Don averaged 21.5 points, 5.5 assists, and 5.5 boards for the T-Birds, leading them to their first Region 9 championship in 23 years. Gervais Green also had a great year, averaging 23.5 points and 5.5 assists and rebounds, just like Bonton. And when these two met in the Region 9 tournament semifinals, it was a showdown. Casper got the win with Isaac scoring 41 points and Gervais scoring 38 points. And fittingly, in that game, they both shot 13 for 25 from the field.
It was fun. It was fun. I actually talked to him during the game and stuff, and I was like, man, let's go out like champs, man. Let's, you know, one-on-one. Let's do it. And we just kept going back and forth, and it was a fun experience. You know, he's a competitor. I'm a competitor. It's a good award to get, you know, especially, you know, with Gervais. He's a great player. So just getting honored at the highest level is a special thing.
And March is National Athletic Training Month. After an injury, the trainers help our athletes get back on the field, court, or ice. The theme of this year's National Athletic Training Month is athletic trainers are healthcare. Our local trainers told me they're the first line of healthcare for the athletes. That includes initially diagnosing and treating an injury on the spot and connecting the athlete with the next healthcare provider they need. Especially at the high school and college level, the athletic trainers provide just as much emotional support as they do physical support.
As an athlete myself, I know what it's like to be injured, and I know how hard it can be to be off of the field. So I love the part of my job is I get to see them from the first time they get hurt to when they're back on the field. So unlike a lot of other healthcare providers, I get to see them through that entire thing, which is a really cool thing to see.
And many of you know today was opening day for Major League Baseball, the official start of the spring for us sports fans. And the Rockies started a 4-game series at the Miami Marlins. Kyle Freeland making his first opening day start of his career. And our 25-year-old ace was dealing, striking out Brian Anderson, then Starlin Castro. He gets Miguel Rojas to ground out to third. Remember, Kyle Freeland was fourth in the NL Cy Young voting last year. He finished today with 7 innings pitched, 5 strikeouts, and just 1 earned run. And at the plate was another good story. Trevor Story. Get out of here because I said so. Missed that catchphrase. Story hammers one to left field, 377 feet, and Rockies win the season opener 6-3 over the Marlins. We've got 3 more in Miami, then 3 in Tampa Bay, before our home opener hosting the Dodgers a week from tomorrow. And tonight, the Nuggets playing at James Harden and the Rockets. And the reigning MVP was doing his thing. Patented double step back on Gary Harris. Hate it had to be him. And the beard loves it. Then Harden cutting and Harden hammering. And on the replay here, you might notice after his dunk, Harden likes to grab his nose. That's because whenever he gets up to high altitude, he acts like he has a nosebleed, which is probably only good in that scenario. Then, third quarter in the post, looks like Gary has him defended, but that's not the case. The Beard scores 38, just 2 points off his season average. Nuggets lose by 17 and slide back to second place in the West. And guys, in our K2 March Madness bracket, our own Hallie Jones, as you know, she just mentioned, very happy about it, has moved into a tie for first with Ryan Berger. They're in the 90th percentile.
We're tied?
You're tied for first. I hate to say it.
That's
Eric
so fun.
Dean in last. Sorry, Eric. He's clapping for himself. And Billy Floyd has Tennessee as the champ, so they are out.
Dunzo.
That is a bracket buster.
Sports there.
No, I was going to talk about the bracket. You're doing pretty well.
Yes.
Am I? Yeah.
You're not winning or you're not losing.
Come on, he knows it.
All right.
Yeah. I love, yeah, the brackets are He's crushing it.
I'm surprised you didn't call it Brat Skitball.
Yep, that's a good one. But thank you, Carmine. We're going to be right back.
It's pretty crazy. It's mad out there. It's